Good morning, out there in YouTube land. How are you doing this wonderful Saturday morning? Well, I struck a good deal on an item at a yard sale today. Not that I need it, but I picked up a table saw for $10. I could not pass it up. It needs some work. It does run. I have to put the handle on. There's a screw that goes in the middle here. It's a delta. It's a 10-inch delta. The table saws I have are 8-inch. Now, she does work, but as you can plainly see, it needs a lot of cleaning. And it needs a bolt over here. Jeez, these damn motorcycles. Unbelievable. See how loose that is? Well, we gotta just put a bolt in like they have here. No biggie at all. And the handle goes right here. It fits on, but it needs a screw. So you hold the handle, Tom, I'll get the saw out. But it does not have a miter gauge, so at least it's got a good rip fence, unlike the Makita that I have, which I had to fix the rip fence on. This one has it, but this don't have the miter gauge either, so. But it's a Delta, so it's a good brand here. Alright. We'll take it right to the backyard here. All right, another thing, I'm a stickler for safety. I'm gonna have to change this plug because they took out the ground prong. We can't have that. We cannot have it, but we are going to test it. The ground is pretty dry here and we should be all right. We're gonna test it as for cutting a piece of wood because it does run. When he plugged it in for me, it did run, but I wanna make sure it's gonna cut the wood under load so there's not a problem with the motor. If there is, then I did not get a good deal at all, but if the motor is good, I think we can fix everything up just perfectly. Alright, as you can see, he made a homemade handle here for the rip fence, but the rip fence is really made well. It's a Delta, so really made good. And the handle, I'll have to look at with my magnifying glass and make sure there's no screw broken off in there. And it looks, from what I can see here, it looks like there's no screw stuck in there, so I should be able to find a screw in one of my bins. Meanwhile, we'll crank up the blade and put the rip fence on, and we'll commence to cut a piece of wood after I get the extension cord out here. My beautiful glasses here. Well, we're going to definitely replace this plug. Now, right out. Now, what I did is on my Craftsman, which if you've been watching my videos all along, I've got an 8-inch Craftsman table saw like this to stand on it. And the rip fence happens to fit right in the groove perfect. Unlike the Makita, this is too wide for the Makita. So we can use this rip fence, and we got a combination blade in there, and I got a piece of wood that has an angle on it here. First time we'll take this wheel off so it doesn't vibrate and fall off on the ground until we get to fix that properly. Here we go. Thank you. seems to work quite well. We're gonna get a piece of 2x4, and we'll see how she cuts through that. We'll be back in a minute. All right, what we're gonna do, crank this blade up. It works just the opposite. To crank the blade up on my Makita, I go clockwise. To crank the blade up on this, I go counterclockwise. So it does work differently. We get the blade up. She just clears the top of that 2x4. And this blade here isn't all that great. But I want to check the motor and make sure the motor isn't bad or anything. Because sometimes, you know, when you put these under load, it could be a problem. There's a reason why people sell these things cheap. And I'm always suspicious. Perfecto. Alright, the first thing I want to do is unplug this. We're going to wind this blade down. We're going to flip it upside down. And I'm going to try to find a screw that'll go in there to hold this handle on. And we're going to turn her upside down and clean out the crap underneath and lubricate everything under there after I blow it all out with the air gun or whatever I'm going to use to clean it out with. So, first thing I want to do is to find a screw that'll go into that shaft there. Well, took me a while to figure out. I have no idea. This must be metric. Some cheap screws that I had, and the standard threads, whatever. This looks like quarter, but I think it's a little less than that. The threads are wrong, so I had a little longer one of one of these that came in one of these packages from the dollar store years ago. That's metric junk and it's made in China and all that crap, but I'm surprised it's being a Delta that it would use metric garbage in here. But fortunately I got something to fit and I put a washer in here, so now the crank mechanism works. So we got to do, first of all, we're going to put a bolt in here. We're going to bolt this down so we get this. This is a fiberglass base and we don't want this to break. This is the same kind of base that's on my Makita table saw, the blue one there that I showed you. Alright, so I'm going to look for a bolt. I'll be back on the video in a minute. Alright, I found a bolt over here in that other corner and I got that all tightened down. Every one of them was loose here. We're going to tighten everything up here because the whole frame here I think is loose. Okay. The whole frame is loose. A lot of crap we got to take out of here, eh? All the crap we got in there. So, on this, I think we're going to have to use an end wrench on that. Not going to be able to. With that bad eyesight, I got to get a whole bunch of wrenches just to find the size. I think this is half inch. Yeah, that's half inch, I think. Half inch end wrench. Okay, that one's tight. They're not all tight, because I can tell by some of these. That one's tight. I'm sure these are tight. This one is. Okay. All right, I had a bugged up bolt that was originally in here on the base here, so I replaced it with a good old American standard here. These are carriage bolts, but they're metric apparently. Leastwise, I think they are. And I don't have anything that would go in there. So we just put a washer on it and do that, because they've been fixed in other places too. Yeah, like here. Somebody had worked on it, but that's tight. And the whole frame is tight. So now I wipe this down. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to brush out all this dirt, and then we're going to put the air gun to it. Of course, you got to be careful of the blade. It's very sharp. You don't want to be ramming your hand down in there. Well, the first thing we're going to do is set this on the ground, get some of this dirt out of here, and then when I get this dirt out of here, then we can lubricate this here. All right, in here is the cranking mechanism that cranks the blade up and down. Well, after I blow all this out, we'll lubricate this here and all to here. So we're going to be doing that right now. But first, we're going to be cleaning out this dirt. All right, if you want to come around the back here, I'll show you what I'm doing. After blowing out all that sawdust and everything else, you can see now we got the mechanism all lubricated and everything. And everything's working smoothly. It isn't binding anymore like it was originally. And we're still going to spray, because I felt a little bit of... You know, you get a little sawdust in the thread sometimes. Okay. Now, this is the blade angling mechanism here. Now, somehow, I think you... This is the lock. I got it unlocked. We should be able to... Actually, I think you got to turn the blade up a little. You should be able to pull. You should be able to pull that over. Still, the lock is off. There we go. Alright, we just put a little WD-40 in the track here. And up through here. A little messy, but... And we still got to wipe this motor down. We didn't get the air gun. Didn't get it all. Alright, I wiped this down, but you're going to get sawdust in here anyways, in use, naturally. And she rolls perfectly. Yep. Now we'll put it back up where it belongs here. And we'll tighten the lever down. Okay, I think, other than cosmetic work, I'll clean this out and I'll put some contact cement in here to hold this, put this back down. I like my stuff looking good as much as possible. So we'll fix that up, but first of all, I want to change that plug. So we'll come back on the video in just a minute here. Okay, I got another plug. It's not the ideal plug I want to put on here. I want to put on one of them industrial, those big yellow jobs. But that's all right. This would be good. It's grounded, nice heavy plug. So we're gonna cut it off here. Most guys would probably just run it that way. I don't believe in that. You gotta have that ground on there for safety. You can't run equipment like that. It's dangerous. So now I'm going to strip the wires back here. The cord is in good shape. I don't need it. It's not all that long, but that's okay. You run it on a heavy extension cord if need be. Some guys use a knife, but you know, it's easier for me to use this. I've been doing it for years. But let's go gentle because you don't want to dig into the wires. That's for sure. I'll tell you, this is a hard one. This is a tough one. All right, now let's see what we got in this end before we do any further work on that.
It's right in there. Wow.
Okay. This is an old plug. I've had this for a long time. I like the big yellow ones because you just slide them up. You loosen the screws and you slide them up into the clamp. You have two metal pieces that come together and clamp under the wire. And you give it a good tug. Make sure it's in there good. But these, you have to wind them around the screw, and winding wires around the screw, you always fray. They always fray, and you got several strands sticking out of it. And the only way I was ever able to do it is to tin these wires with a soldering iron, which is not really the way you should do it, but at least when you put it under the screw, you know, you'll get all the wire in there, you know, not just half the wire. So we get this here. All right. The green wire, of course, goes on the ground, so we're going to strip that. That looks like about 18 gauge. Can't read that without my magnifying glass. Now we'll start down here in the larger area. Yeah, that's good. We got the plug on. Now we just put the cover over it. There's a few strands out, but they ain't going to get it any better than that without tinning the wires. That's the only way you can do it better. Got to tin the wires. That's why I don't really like these kind of plugs, because of that. I always have trouble with the wires going around the screws. You have to tin them. I don't care what anybody says. You got to tin the wires. You don't. They're harder to work with that way, but it's the only way you're going to get it under the screw and get all the strands under the screw, because there's always strands that hang out. Now we tighten up the strain relief, which is right here. That's so you don't pull the wire out of the plug. You're not supposed to pull the plug out of the wall by the cord anyways, but I've known people that do that.
Yeah, I did it with my amplifier once.
Yeah, well, you don't want to do that again. All right. Okay. we'll give it a try again now. We'll see how she works. Now we're going to crank this up. I got to remember, I got to go counterclockwise to crank up. I'm used to going clockwise. Oh, she works nice and easy now. The screw that I put in here is one of these Chinese junky, crappy metric junk garbage, but it keeps loosening up. I got to go to the hardware store and get something better. But I want to show you now that we can turn the blade perfectly. Now, we'll unplug the saw here. Okay, we're unplugged. Always take the plug out before you do anything like this. We want to double check. We don't believe anything here. Okay, never believe that. We want to make sure the blade is properly angled. She needs to really be pushed over and then locked down. Okay, that's what you want. Don't go by this, because if you come over here, look, we got to adjust the guide. So the point is way off the zero here, so we're going to try to get a screwdriver down in here and bring that pointer down. I've got to get my stool out so I can get my skinny, ugly ass planted. I think a Phillips. Try both of them. Get my reading glasses here because I'm going to need them. These are my good glasses. These aren't the beautiful ones that I wore earlier when I was cutting wood. Okay, I think it's Phillips. We're going to, I don't know if you can see that. We're going to try to move that if we can. It doesn't move very much. It does not move very much. Alright, what it's got to be is right about there. So, being that I'm a left-handed guy, I got to operate the screwdriver with my right hand. Isn't that something? I'm not very good at that. I never really pay too much attention. These are just the rough. I can't even see the slot in the screwdriver. Okay. All right, we're sitting on that. We could put a little mark on this here to do that, but we're not going to worry about that. Now I bring the blade down. How nice and smooth it is. So the next thing I got to do, the blade's all down all the way past the below the deck. We got to glue this down, and we want to paint the base. It's rusty as hell here with sand. It. We're not doing that on video. We just want to glue this down. Well, I did a quick paint job on it. It had a lot of rust and it was very hard to sand, but I hate sanding, so it really shows. That's why my bodywork never looks good, because I hate sanding. I really do. Anyways, it looks a lot better than it did. I contact cemented this here, and I hope it holds. Otherwise, if not, I'll put a black piece of duct tape right across here. But anyways, it looks good, but they got the new safe plug on there now, and we're all set. I want to thank you for watching. This has been a few years since I got any good deals at a yard sale. As a matter of fact, the last few years there's been virtually nothing at any yard sale except a bunch of kid stuff and clothing and stuff like that. And games and junk like that, you know. All right. Well, thank you for watching, folks. Take care.